Praise the Lord, Revival Center family. Thank you for taking the time to let me just speak into your homes and your lives and pray peace over you, your mind, your body, and your spirit. I know this is a chaotic time and season for all of us. Just the chaos that comes with Christmas. The presents and the packaging. I'm aware of it all. And I pray the name of Jesus over you, over your family, over your mind. And in this holiday season, I want to just take a minute and let you know I'm thinking of you and your family, and you're in my mind, your health, your well-being. I would that you would prosper, the scripture says, and be in good health as your soul prospers. I want you to take time in this season where we reflect on the birth of the Messiah, and I want you to think about and reflect your family. Not only your biological family, but also the family, the body of Christ. And just be thankful, be mindful of the goodness and the blessing of God that is around us all. I want you to have a great Christmas season. I want you to have a blessed holiday season. And I want you to nourish your soul. This is a public service announcement before you get into all of the food and festivities. I want you to nourish your soul. I encourage you to be intentional about your prayer life. Be intentional about it. Start your day seeking the Lord, calling on the name of the Lord, inquiring of the Lord. And also, I want you to continue to study the Word of God and let that be a part of your diet. The Bible said in Job that I have esteemed the words of your mouth more than my necessary food. So those are some things I want you to pause and consider as I greet you and tell you how much we love and appreciate you. And also the good gifts that you're enjoying. Tell your children exactly where they come from. My favorite scripture is every good and perfect gift comes down from the Father above, in whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning. That's one of my favorite scriptures. Every good thing that we enjoy in this holiday season, it comes from God. The life, the liberties, the food, the houses we live in, the cars we drive, the clothes that are on our back, the toys and the presents that are under the tree, it comes from God. Tell your spouse, tell your children exactly the good things that we enjoy. It all comes from the Father above, in whom there is no variableness. God doesn't have variables. He doesn't have good days and bad days. He is God. Neither shadow of turning. God doesn't have degrees where some days He's more God or He's less God. Every good thing we have comes from God. And I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for that in my life and my family and in our church family. And I know some of you are battling loneliness. I understand that. You can't see your parents. You can't see your loved ones. But I want to tell you, you may feel lonely, but you are not alone. God is a very present help in a time of trouble. I pray that many, many times. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. And so I want to encourage you for just a few moments this evening as you watch this and tell you, I am for you, I am with you, I stand with you. But also the great shepherd stands with us and leads us and helps us and strengthens us. Don't get caught up in the chaos and miss the Christ. I also want to tell you something I'm praying about and I'm considering. I haven't made up my mind completely, but I'm considering postponing our in-person services this coming Sunday. I am studying the data and the statistics, and I haven't made a formal announcement about postponing this coming Sunday's in-person service, but I am prayerfully considering that. I want to give us ample time and opportunity for all of us to be well and healthy and recovered, and that is my continued prayer and belief. And I think you know by now that I approach every decision with much gravity and sincerity and prayerfulness. So I am considering postponing this coming Sunday's in-person service out of abundance of caution. And I'm praying about that. And I haven't got a chance to communicate with our staff about what my formal decision and final decision is, but I'm considering it. And I'm praying about it. And I'm seeking the Lord about it. And I might possibly do so out of abundance of caution for everyone's health in general. But I haven't decided firmly and finally, because I'm still in the process of that decision. But in light of those things, I am incredibly encouraged and strengthened by God. In this season, as we reflect God and the goodness of God, I know this Christmas is different than any other Christmas we've ever experienced. I know this is unprecedented times, and I understand that. But in light of that, the peace of God I feel in my soul. I know in whom I have believed, and I know He is able to keep that which I committed to Him. And that is the same for you and your family. So I greet you. I love you. My wife and I thank you for all of the kindness and the generosity that you have bestowed on us. It is appreciated, and we are so grateful for it. I pray the blessing of the Lord be on you to keep you and watch over you. May His face shine down on you, and may the Lord give you peace. Until I see you again, in Jesus' name, God bless you.